Have you invested in Google Workspace, but you have the feeling in the back of your mind that you're not quite using all the features, or you're not quite getting everything you should be out of the platform? In this video, I'm going to share with you some tips on how you can get up to speed and supercharge your workspace. My name is Pete Moriarty, and we run a consulting business called IT Genius, and we've helped literally thousands of business owners all over the world with their Google Workspace subscriptions. Now, we help small and medium-sized businesses, right from sole traders to organizations with hundreds or even thousands of employees, to get more value out of their tech tools. And Google Workspace is the primary tool that we work with. Now, we also work with CRM systems and customer service and management systems and even virtual phone systems as well. But we primarily work with businesses in the Google ecosystem and help them get more out of the platform. Now, if you're an administrator of Workspace, or you're a leader or a business owner in the company that you're working for, well, these tips are going to help you to make sure that your team are getting the most out of the business's investment in this platform. So without further ado, let's get started with our first tip. Now, for most of these, you're going to need access to the administration panel. If you don't already have that, contact the owner of the business or the person who has actually resold your Workspace subscription to you. Now, the number one feature to switch on is something called Rapid Release. And this is actually hidden away in the admin panel. What this does is this gives your account the latest features that come from Google as soon as they are released. Now, typically when Google releases new features, sometimes they make it to the mainstream media, sometimes they don't. I'm going to touch a little bit more about that further in the video. But for many businesses, usually once the time the feature is released after a couple of weeks on the standard release, you know, the kind of fanfare has died down and the exciting new feature is suddenly down the bottom of the priority list behind the rest of your work. Now, when you switch on Rapid Release, no matter where you are in the world, you're going to be one of the first people to get access to new features. And what that's going to do is that's going to allow you to try out the features first and potentially roll them out to your team first. So that's my first step to make sure that you're keeping up to date with everything that Google releases. Next up, you want to actually try out these features as they're released. And what I like to do is a little bit of a kind of experiment each time a new feature comes out. Now, I might record a video and share that with my team. If I'm excited about it, I might share a screenshot into our Google chat and let the team know, hey, I've just found this new feature in Google. Did you know that that was there? But if you're someone who's in an HR or a operations role and you're interested in your team having the best productivity possible, well, it's very important for you to both be trying out the new features and then being ready to potentially share them with your team. Now, as much as possible, we recommend you stick with a Google strategy and a Google first strategy right across your business. And what we mean by that is wherever possible to use Google's productivity tools and the Google Workspace ecosystem for all the business that you're doing. Ideally, you want to avoid using third-party tools like Zoom or Slack, which could be a double up to tools that are already available within Google's ecosystem. Now, not only do you have the risks of subscription overwhelm and additional costs piling up, but you also potentially introduce security risks and data loss risks using third-party applications as well. We've got other videos covering the perils of using either Zoom or Slack inside your business when you already have a Google Workspace subscription. Now, if you want to keep on top of the latest updates that are actually coming out for Google, well, you want to do that on the G Suite Updates blog. And this is something you can subscribe to, receive as email alerts or tweets or however you like to get your blogs. That's the best way to keep up to date with the Google updates that are flowing through into your Workspace account. This is where Google catalogs each new release that is happening from the small to the large. Now, from time to time, we'll actually create videos on this channel and let you know when there's exciting new features that are being released and ones that you want to keep tabs on as a business owner. But if you want to see them coming through for yourself, then the best thing to do is make sure you subscribe to the updates blog and make sure you're reading that regularly. One of the other things that's really great is that there is a monthly summary of all of the updates that come out into the ecosystem. So if you want to go to one place once a month and browse through all the updates, well, that's a great place to start. Next tip is you want to make sure that you're actually fully implementing the Google Workspace solution and ecosystem. For many businesses, Workspace was set up by a previous employee, or maybe it was set up by a web developer, or maybe you put it in place when you had an issue with a server and it was never fully implemented with all of the tools. And for many businesses who work with us, we find that they come along and say, you know what, I've got this Google Workspace thing, but I really don't feel like I'm using it to its full potential. And so I recommend that you actually fully implement Google Workspace. And that means both training your team and completely moving off other systems that you're using. Do you find that some of your team members are still using Microsoft Office format documents inside the business? Or maybe they're still using Keynote for presentations when you have great document formats with Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Slides as well in the business, with advantages to using the Google ecosystem and Google Drive over legacy document formats. If these kind of warning signs are still there in your business, well then it might be a case of not having fully implemented and not effectively managed change inside the business. Now, we have other videos on implementing G Suite and leading your team through change, and I recommend you check those out to learn more about how to fully implement new technology systems in an effective way inside your business. Finally, and this is probably the most important point, is training your team. Ensuring that your team are able to actually use and work with the tools that are right in front of you. Now, we see businesses take a different approach to training, whether it's working one-on-one with someone, whether it's a part of recorded videos as part of an onboarding process, or if you're running training clinics from time to time to help with your team members' skills. You may even share your team members some of the videos on our YouTube channel. We would love that if we can help to teach them how to get more out of the Google ecosystem. And you can find some videos in our playlist specifically related to Google Workspace. But making sure your team are actually trained is a very easy way to get more productivity out of your team and make sure that you're realizing the full investment of Google Workspace. Now, if you're a new administrator to Workspace and you want to learn more about how to actually operate the admin controls, well, you might be interested in our free administrator course, all for Google Workspace subscribers. Now, that's actually available via our transfer in offer down below. You just need to transfer your license billing to IT Genius. Doesn't cost you any extra, but you get access to Genius Academy. Now, inside Genius Academy, you get a Google Classroom full of videos for both your team to learn how to use Google Workspace, but also for administrators to learn how to use the back end of the platform and how to actually get more value out of Google Workspace right across the board. And if you're interested in that, not only do you get access to our library of videos, but you get a free account check and some basic support from our team as well. When you're onboarding and offboarding staff, our team have options available if you're looking for help with everything Google. And if you're looking for premium support and consulting, we have our concierge service available, which helps you to get access to third-party plugins and features, professional support from our team, and our project management team can either create dashboards for you or develop custom solutions for your business in the Google ecosystem. If you're interested in any of those, jump onto the consultation link below, and if you qualify, one of our team will book in a call to schedule talking to your business. Now, we work with businesses all over the world, from sole operators up to organizations with hundreds or even thousands of employees. And if we can help you, we'd love to be a part of your business journey. If you're interested in more videos like this, hit subscribe, check out the rest of our channel, and you might be interested to learn about our growth roadmap. That's where we take businesses through different stages of technology strategy based on the stage of business that you are at right now. And we help you let know what are the technology tools that you need to make sure your business is successful at each different stage of business. Check out our playlists on the channel to learn more about the growth roadmap. And if you like this content, give me a thumbs up. I'd love to know what you think about this, if I missed anything, or if you've got any comments to add, jump them down in the comments below and I will answer as soon as I can. Take care and see you in the next video.